When I grew up in a very religious household.
Like, my family was Seventh-day Adventist, and we had to keep the Sabbath every Friday night and every Saturday, okay? And they were very, very, very religious. And so between the abuse, between the addiction I saw my family members go through, I just felt like, you know what? This whole God stuff ain't real. And I just decided for myself that I didn't believe in God. I just didn't believe that God existed at all. I felt like if God was around, why did I get abused? Why did I get molested? Why did I get beat? Why did I go through this? Why is my mom on drugs? Like, I had all these questions that I'm sure a lot of young people go through, you know, when they're trying to find themselves and trying to find their spirituality, you know? I had a friend that was in my little atheist clique that had gotten born again, and I was like, you betrayed us, okay? I was like, I felt like she literally betrayed us, you know, because she went over there and got born again. And so she would always talk to me about the Lord. And I was like, honey, I'm not doing that. Like, I'm smarter than that, right? And I got a call about my grandfather. It was my step-grandfather, Frank Noko, who my grandmother was married to, who was like a, you know, he pretty much raised us. He had gotten cancer, and we would take turns going home to help my grandmother to take care of him. And so I remember it was my turn to go home, you know, and I went home, and one of my best friends from back in the day, she's still one of my best friends today. Her name is Mecca. She's in a group called Diggable Planets. Ladybug, I remember she came with me to help me, you know, because she had dealt with that too.
You know, you could tell that it was definitely affecting her. She was trying not to let it keep her down, you know, her energy and her spirit down. So to get a break from the house and being, you know, around that, we would go and kick it with some friends in her neighborhood to kind of just balance that out.
I remember she left, and I was like, I was afraid for my grandmother to be there, you know, with my grandfather by herself. You know, that was this thing that was in my head. Like, I wanted to go smoke weed. I was trying to hang out. I was like, hey, I'm trying to go get high. But I'm scared to leave grandma in the house, right? Just in case he had passed. And I remember saying, if you really God, then let me know when he about to pass so I could at least go help my grandmother. I remember just saying it, just being funny, right? So I'm getting high with a friend, and I swear it was like I heard go home. I was like, God. It was like crazy. I know it sounds crazy. I don't even tell the story like this. Anyway, but I felt like, oh my God, he's about to die. I gotta go home. And so I left just so I could see if he was really passing, because it was this weird feeling. I closed the door, I sat down, and then all of a sudden my grandmother started screaming. And I ran up there, and she's like, he's gone. But it was literally when I walked in the house, right? Some people may say, oh, that's what made you believe in God. Well, that's what made me start thinking that maybe I should be a little open to God. Like, it just sat with me. And by the time I went back to California, I remember calling up my friend who had gotten born again. And I said, I think I want to go to church because I think I need to be a little more open to God. They got me. They got me. And to this day, I believe in God so much. And, you know, I went through my super duper uber Christian time, right? Where, oh, I wasn't nobody as saved as me, okay? Anyway, so I became very born again. I stopped drugs. I quit the cocaine, quit the marijuana, quit the alcohol, quit the cigarettes. Quit sex. Can you believe it? I went 8 years celibate. I had so much sex that I was like, she need a sabbatical, okay? She need to sit down for a while, right? Used to joke about it, right? And then I remember after 8 years, I was like, Lord, can we loose it now? Because I need some sex, okay?